My next guest, Tomas Lares, is the founder and president of United Abolitionist, a network of first responders working to stop all forms of human trafficking across the nation. Hi, thank you so much for being here with us.
Thank you, Commissioner. Good to be here.
And I've heard a lot already about all the great work that you've been doing. Tell us about yourself and the United Abolitionist Network.
My undergrad is actually in psychology, and also did some studies in the School of Social Work at the University of Central Florida. But my first job was with Big Brothers Big Sisters here in Central Florida. And so I started seeing, at the time we didn't call it human trafficking, but started seeing kids that were being trafficked by their parents for drugs. And so that's really what sparked me to want to go into this field.
What forms of human trafficking is going on?
So here in Florida, unfortunately, we have all the forms. So there's sex trafficking, labor trafficking, domestic servitude of adult persons, minors, foreign-born and domestic. And so we see all the different forms here in Florida.
What are the ways to prevent human trafficking?
Some of the things that are encouraging is that the schools are getting more involved, usually by district, of getting some kind of education. In the state of Florida, there is a rule for school districts to begin to do prevention and education through the health departments. And so here in Orange County, we have been fortunate to have a lot of different schools, middle schools particularly, and high schools that will bring in various agencies that are talking about online safety, you know, don't trust everybody on social media or even gaming and chatting. And so that's really important to have prevention versus later than intervention.
Yeah, so you mentioned the gaming and social media. I think a lot of people may think of the movie Taken as being human trafficking. Yeah. But, I mean, our youth are probably exposed to it all the time.
That's a great point, Commissioner, because the movie Taken was great because it brought mass awareness, but it's really the exception to how someone's trafficked, very small percentage, even globally. Here in Central Florida, it's really kids being lured by the wrong kind of people. It doesn't matter your social and economic class, your race, your gender. These traffickers are looking for vulnerabilities. And so a lot of the youth are maybe looking for love in all the wrong places, and they're being targeted.
What are services that are provided by your organization and others here in Central Florida?
So in the continuum of care, the United Abolitionist Place is really that first responder. So we have a 24/7 hotline that started in 2010, and we answer calls, again, mainly for adult victims, male and female, sex and labor trafficking. Because of the Florida statute with the Department of Children and Families, any calls that come in for minors, maybe someone suspecting it, we have a lot of mothers call that they believe their kid is being trafficked. We refer them to the Department of Children and Families abuse hotline with their maltreatment code. And so that is our job, is that first response, those critical hours. And so for many years, I've been able to go out with vice units here in Circuit 9 with the Metropolitan Bureau of Investigation. When there was calls, maybe somebody was picked up on OBT or International Drive, or was being trafficked through social media.
And once they're identified, what's the process, or what do they go through in order to receive the care that they need?
So part of that is that first response is critical, making them feel comfortable. So we call it being victim-centered, mm-hmm. Being trauma-informed. A lot of the victims don't trust the law enforcement. And they've been maybe through a child welfare system, wherever they come from in the country. And so we make sure that they feel comfortable in letting them know we're a nonprofit, we're non-governmental, our advocates, and that we are here to help them. Mm-hmm. So some of them may want to reunify with family, others may want to go to a program. And so those are some of the things we offer. We also started the rescue backpacks. And so we have clothes and hygiene products, and that we give them to that individual, no matter if they want help or not, and let them know that we're here. We give them our hotline number. Mm-hmm. Many of the vulnerabilities in the complex post-traumatic stress disorder that they have because of all the sexual assault and mm-hmm. being trafficked, again, they don't trust anyone. So that building that rapport And trust is critical in that first response that we do.
Tell us about the Greater Orlando Human Trafficking Task Force.
So it has recently been renamed to the Central Florida Human Trafficking Task Force, but that began actually in September of 2007. So it's been an incredible community of stakeholders. So we have law enforcement, prosecutors, NGOs, really those care providers here in our community that come together. And we have started really monthly meetings way back then, and we continue to meet with subcommittees. And so it's really important, that power of collaboration. And we all know that the proverb, it takes a village. And in order to help these victims, survivors of trafficking, we need to all come together, and we do here.
What can the community do to support and become involved?
So the community, there's a lot of on-ramps and opportunities, including the backpack drive. A lot of groups, it could be civic, business groups, church groups, will do backpacks for us, mm-hmm. Because we're able to give those out to all law enforcement, the sheriff's office, the vice units, child welfare workers, and those front runner care providers. And so the backpack drive is probably one of our most popular. They can also really, and we know knowledge is power, so get informed, know what kind of trafficking is occurring. There's many of our organizations on the task force that do prevention, education. The United Abolitionist has a program at Rosen College of Hospitality, and so we're training the future hospitality leaders, but also we have courses for the hospitality industry here, knowing that tourism is really important, and if we can prevent it, and we can equip workers on how to identify and report it, then we're going to continue to keep our community safe. And, you know, we want to be family friendly to welcome our tourists.
Yeah, definitely. And where can the community or our viewers find out more about the backpack drive that you have and other ways that they can get involved?
Sure. That's stophumantrafficking.com is our website. And we're also on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn. And they can find out about the backpack drive, the next training. On January 27th and 28th, we have our 14th annual Human Trafficking Awareness Days. And we bring everyone together, the governmental and non-governmental stakeholders here in our region, to talk about what they're doing, to give volunteer opportunities, and really equip the community on what to look for.
Well, thank you so much for being here and for providing all of this information and all the wonderful services that you're providing to people out there who need it.
Thank you, Commissioner, for the opportunity.
Thank you.